In this video, we will learn about the ScanStation P40's scan viewer, which is a really useful tool. It allows a completed scan to be checked to make sure all is correct before returning to the office, and also allows further subscans to be defined in those areas which have been visually identified to need additional scanning. Using the scan viewer can really save a lot of time and money. After the live preview of a scan has finished, the resulting point cloud is displayed in the scan viewer. In this screen, the colour of a point cloud can be changed, as well as its viewpoint and perspective. In addition, several commands are provided to define and start further subscans as batch jobs, based on an easy fence selection. By default, the point cloud is mapped with an intensity rainbow color map, ranging from red for low reflective points to blue for high reflective points. This makes it easy to identify scanned objects simply by their reflectivity. With the colorize button, we can switch to a grayscale intensity mapping, with black for low reflective points and white for high reflective points. This display mode is close to a black and white film, and some users feel more comfortable with it. By picking the pan button, we can activate the pan mode to move the current scan in the screen to any direction. We can left pan the displayed scene, or we can move it to the right, or we can move the whole scene up and down. The zoom in button zooms to the center of the scan. It can be repeated multiple times to get the details of an area of interest. With the zoom out button, we can zoom back out step by step. In case of getting lost in the zoom and pan process, we can use the zoom all command to zoom back and fit the complete scan back to the screen. With the seek command, we can select a point in the scan viewer and define it as the new center. As a result, the entire point cloud is moved in horizontal and vertical direction, so that the selected point is now the new center. Finally, the view button provides the option to switch from a 2D planar view to a 3D spherical view of the point cloud. The 3D spherical view is a plus for overhead views, and all zoom and pan commands work in this mode as well. The 2D view is the view of choice for panoramic views. All these commands can be combined for a quick and easy navigation in the current point cloud. From an existing scan, we can define subscans, which means it is possible to document a scene not only with one single scan setting, but with different scan settings optimized for each sub-area. First of all, we open the Detail Scan Parameters screen. Here we can define the subscan settings similar to the standard scan settings. Let's define a setting like this. We set EDM mode to speed and resolution basis to fixed distance. With the sliders, we define a resolution of 25mm at 10m and a normal sensitivity, and finally we confirm these settings. Back in the scan viewer screen, we pan and zoom to the area to be scanned. Then we draw a fence around it. The fenced area will be displayed in inverted colours. To start a single subscan with this scan definition, we could now press the scan button. But let's think of a series of fenced subscans, and all of them with different scan settings. Next, we have to press the add scan button in order to save the first subscan with all its settings. With the View Scan List button, we can open the scan list and check the saved scan. The information about the fenced area, in combination with the selected resolution, have been transformed into a number of points in horizontal and vertical direction. Let's return to the scan viewer and add some more subscans. For a completely different definition of the next subscan, we set EDM mode to range and sensitivity to high. In resolution basis, we opt for distance to object, and then in resolution for 12mm at object, Back in the scan viewer screen, we pan the scene and zoom to our area of interest. Then we fence a second area in the point cloud. This area will also be added as a subscan to the scan list. In the scan list, this second subscan is now listed with 12mm resolution as defined. But the distance is now the median distance calculated from all fenced points. We can grow this list by adding more subscans or press the delete button to delete a selected subscan from this list. Once we are okay with our list, we return to the scan viewer screen. Here we press the scan button. Now the scanner will start to read the subscans from the list and scan area by area as defined. Finally, we end up with a main scan and two subscans. We can use the next button and the previous button to browse forward or backward from one scan to another in this station. By pressing the target button, target scans can be defined and started in a similar way for automatic target center detection, but this will be covered in another video. Two important buttons at the very top remain. With the minimize button, we can shrink the whole toolbar for a better visibility. Pressing the button again brings back the whole toolbar to its original size. To leave the scan viewer and get back to the scan parameter screen, we press the escape button. As long as the scanner did not move to a new station, we can return from the scan parameter screen to the scan viewer with the view scan button. In this video, we discussed how to use the scan viewer, especially how to switch the intensity coloring, how to navigate with zoom and pan commands, and how to switch between 2D and 3D point cloud view. We also learned how to define subscans and how to start them as a batch job. Thank you for watching this video.